snapshots of moments in time. Photographs that define who we are and what we are, where we have been and where we are going. This was our time. Writer Tom Wolfe called it the Me Decade. TV talk show host Dick Cavett said there were the Roaring Twenties and the Fabulous Fifties, but no such neat phrase encompassed this astounding era, unless maybe we called it the Preposterous Decade. For if a writer crammed even half of its events into an invented decade, he'd be accused of overdoing it. It was America in the 1970s. At the time, most of us believed we were living in boring times. After all, how could it compare with our parents' time, the children of the Great Depression, the generation that saved the world in the Second World War, the generation that ushered in the time of prosperity and built the American middle class, the generation that gave us a baby boom? How could we compete? And then we remember Vietnam, the Watergate scandal, the fight for women's rights, urban riots, anti-war protests, Kent State, airline hijacking, environmental regulation, space shots, the setting of highway speed limits, terrorists at the Munich Olympics, oil crisis, gasoline shortages, serial killers, three U.S. presidents, and stadium rock. We turned inward, focusing on the betterment of body and soul. If we couldn't change the world, we would change ourselves by eating health food, joining in counter groups, losing ourselves in transcendental meditation. We wobbled on platform shoes, strutted in polyester leisure suits, and grooved to the disco beat. We bought mood rings, pet rocks, smiley faces, Rubik's cubes, clackers, and pop rocks. And just as the fragility of Earth was becoming painfully clear, we saw the first pictures of Mars, and "May the Force Be With You" echoed from a galaxy far, far away. That place, Fort Knox, Fort Knox High School. Our houses, our quarters, the buildings, special places that mark the way through a time of great transition. What a ride it was. We were the last generation before computers, before cell phones, before video games, before Twitter, before Facebook. We remember an America that once was and will never be again. Simpler times, great times. Remember being outdoors, always outdoors, with the sun on your face and few cares in the world, loving life. Loving life with the people in this room. For we were innocent once, and oh, so young.
Breath away, and there you will be, so young and carefree. Again, you will see that place in time. So gold, still away into that. You thought that all would last forever, but like the weather, nothing can ever and be in time. Stay gold. But can it be when we can see so vividly a memory? And yes, you say, so must the day to fade away and leave a ray of sun. So yet filled with sorrow and compassion, though not imagined, all things that happen will age to old, though gold, 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 though
and all the others in between. Remember, Do you remember the times of your life? While you may collect the dreams you dream today, remember, will you remember?
Faces, all these faces, military brats, legacies of childhood inside the fortress. The writer, Mary Edward Wirtz, said, "We are the children of warriors. We did not choose this role, but we perpetuate it with pride. We are the children of soldiers. Our minds, our hearts return to us time and time again to this path. It is an attitude, a way of being. Our souls are hammered out on the forge of discipline and dedication, of mission and service to others, of loss and sacrifice in the name of something larger than ourselves. Our homes are so many that we barely consider them places. They are simply the shared experience of the military and its many legacies. Our true home was hardship, and we learned from it. Our home is a rich fund of values and ideals. Our way of life is a special quality of freedom that one can only obtain, ironically enough, inside this ironclad fortress."